السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Our talk again today, our reminder today about clemency and forbearance, indulgence and endurance. Two incidents happened in Antakya, one 2016 and one 2018. In 2016, we were organizing a workshop to transfer knowledge and experience between us and the Syrian displaced refugees in Turkey. And while we're discussing certain issues, a young woman or young girl stood up to show us, to explain the suffering that she had from so-called Muslim or Islamic armed groups. When she said Islamic armed groups, this made few men furious and they started to shout, to scream at her, to yell at her, to show their fist at her. And the young girl was so shocked and afraid for her life. What happened? Our role was to cool things down and try to tell them, please, she means that this is happening not only in this part of the world, but happening in different parts of the world, and we have seen it in different countries when the armed conflict was there. And we are coming here to try to show you how the outside world is looking at us in Syria or here in Antakya or any other place in the world. Please, this is our opinion. You take it or you leave it. But actually try to cool down, because we need to come together to build one community together. The second incident happened actually in the same city 2 years afterwards, in August 2018. Another workshop, which was talking about, my session was talking about how to exist and live together. The existence between whom? Between the citizens, the Syrian citizens, who left Syria and they are living in different countries like Turkey, Lebanon, Jordan, and the displaced Syrian citizen inside Syria itself, and the Syrian citizens who still are inside their own cities and they did not actually move outside the city. And they are not actually. Soon I mentioned the word of existence or ta'ayush in Arabic language, and a woman stood up and she's shouting at me, said that since you came yesterday, you have a hidden agenda trying to let us to coexist and live and work with the current regime in Syria. I said, "What? Who said that? I never mentioned a political statement. I never mentioned Syrian government. I never mentioned anything like this." And this was live on my Facebook if you want to look at it. I said, I am talking about the Syrian people, which now become the clusters of people with different cultures, different values, different customs, different even beliefs, which have been imposed to them by the culture of war, displacement, immigration, and. After I mentioned this to the woman, a handful or more or less of those orators who started to give speeches, give poetry, and reciting Quran and others, and I let everybody speak because I did not want to make any one of them to become shaheed or martyr. When everybody finished, I explained my opinion another time, and I told them, if you cannot become one nation as you were before, you will never be able to rebuild Syria again. You become now clusters of human beings of different values, culture, customs, tradition, and even faith. You and us have to create an industry and a philosophy, a new industry and the philosophy to build the new Syria, and to make the Syrian to live together under one roof. And here you have to be careful when you find those young men giving speeches and were very good communicator and orator. Helm, endurance, indulgence is the answer. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.